Hey, Heath.
Hey, Kevin.
You've been through my light bulb drawer.
Does it look familiar to do that?
It does. I've got one of everything in a box because I think I'm always going to need them.
Yeah, we have shelves full of these things, too.
Right? Why are they all here?
So, went to the supply house trying to get some fluorescent tubes, older fluorescent tubes, for a customer just to replace and repair a light real quick.
Right.
Having a hard time getting some of these now.
Really?
Yeah. And I was being told that they're going to be more and more difficult to get, and I'm probably better off changing that fixture to something newer.
They're phasing out fluorescents.
Yeah, they're phasing those out like they did to some of the incandescents.
Oh, my goodness.
So that kind of started me down a rabbit hole of, how do we even get here, and where did this all start?
All right.
So here we are.
Where did it all start?
So it started when I started looking. A gentleman in 1802 was the first one to actually take a battery and apply power to some type of filament and get it to glow. I mean, very little, very limited, but it was the start of it all. From there, a bunch of scientists, ones we know the names of and some we don't, jumped on and created what we have now as the incandescent bulb.
So what is the actual science of how this is making light?
So what we're doing is actually applying current to a filament inside.
Which is that little sort of spring-looking
spring-looking piece. Once we do that, that gets hot and actually glows, and that glow is what we're using for the light.
Okay. So magnificent in its day.
Amazing.
Right. But as you point out, it's really just making
heat.
Not
super efficient. Yeah. Right. So we're getting about 10% light, 90% heat.
Okay.
So a lot of that energy is really being lost.
We can improve the efficiency. They don't last as long as they should either.
They don't. You know, usually a couple of years, and there are also some variables of other things. Not to say there isn't an exception to the rule. I think there's one called the Centennial Light that's in California in a firehouse.
I've heard about this.
Over 100 years running.
That's crazy.
Still going. I mean, it started out as a 60-watt bulb. It's down to a 4-watt. But yeah, it's still there.
I'm down to about a 4-watt myself. So we move from the incandescent to the fluorescent.
Right.
We're used to seeing these, so the tubes that sort of go up above us sit in banks of 3 or 4.
Exactly. You'll see those in commercial applications, industrial. We'll see that kind of thing. And this works by two electrodes on the end get current as well. And inside, there's a gas, mercury, and phosphorus.
So we've got these pins on either side. And what's going on with the...
Once we apply the charge, everything gets excited, we can actually see that phosphor.
I'll take your word on that one. So this is roughly how much more efficient than, say, the incandescents?
Depending on the size and the type you're using, we'll say roughly 5 times more efficient.
Which is why we all started moving to them.
We started moving to them, so we started to get the oil crunch. We wanted to find a way to use them residentially, but obviously that tube isn't going to fit where that goes.
So when you want to make them so that they fit in your desk side lamp or whatever, you need that.
And yep,
which is interesting because, you know, old Mr. Edison's invention may be on its way out, but that screw base
became the standard.
And everything we own.
Everything, yeah.
So you've got to sort of make these fit into the existing fixtures.
Yep. So an engineer in the 70s found a way to take that tube, coil it, and make it fit in the place of those bulbs.
Yeah, it's good looking too. Said no one ever.
Said no one.
All right. So we can do better in terms of efficiency.
We can, yeah.
And that takes us to these.
The LEDs.
And so what is the actual science in terms of how these make light?
So it literally stands for light emitting diode. And what we're doing is applying current to this, going through multiple electronics, depending on the size and the type of lamp that it is. And we're lighting up the diode. That's what you're seeing.
And when you say diode, every one of those little yellow squares that we see right there is one of those diodes. So
right,
it's kind of like a little computer chip, basically.
Exactly. And we're just giving it a glow.
Yeah. And when these things came out, they were wonky. They were about as wonky as these things were when they came out, right?
They were ugly. They were expensive. There were a million different styles. Everyone was trying everything to make them work. And now they really have them down.
So you approve?
It took a while. I'm not going to lie. They had their place. You know, I was a little bit of a snob. My exterior lights in my own house, I have clear glass. I wanted the, you know, clear candelabra bulbs because it was a cleaner look. When these first came out, you had, you know, a white base and then kind of a clear top, and it just didn't look good.
Didn't like it.
Now you can get them like this.
Yeah.
These look great.
And they work.
They work great. It's hard to pass up now.
And, you know, they're literally trying to replicate the old Edison bulb because we are creatures of habit, so we want to feel.
I still want that look.
Yeah, it is.
And I still want that color.
Yeah. So we get floods in LEDs, we get the A lamps in LEDs, we get the
even replacements for the fluorescent tubes, yeah.
And how much more efficient is an LED?
So on something like this, if we took a 60-watt incandescent to a 60-watt equivalent LED, the LED is probably using somewhere around 6 watts. So it's almost, it can be up to 10 times more efficient. It's hard to pass up.
And these things go forever.
In theory, they last a long time. Again, it's electronic. Sometimes they are prone to failure, but on average, you're gonna get much more life and much more efficiency compared to the incandescent or even the fluorescent.
It's kind of nice to know that the centennial bulb still has them beat. All right, well, I appreciate it, Heath.
All right.
You're coming around. I think this is probably on its way out.
Yeah, we're getting there.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. This Old House has got a video for just about every home improvement project, so be sure to check out the others. And if you like what you see, click on the subscribe button. Make sure that you get our newest videos right in your feed.